Welcome to Milroy United Methodist Church. We are sincerely glad that you chose to take the time today to gather and worship with us. I have a couple of announcements I want to share with you, though, before we begin. First of all, the face-to-face worship. I mentioned this last time, I want to mention it again. July 5th is when we're going to come back for face-to-face worship. Bring your mask. Expect to be distanced from each other. So it means you may not sit in your normal pew. Just be prepared for that. But online worship will still be here. So if you're not comfortable returning on July 5th, watch it online. That's fine also. Just want to let you know that option is going to be there. Second thing I want to share is we prepared, and Pat Kerrigan's Celebration of Life is going to be August 1st at 10 a.m., Now, that's the same day Carol Anna gets married, so we can celebrate twice that day. In the morning at 10 a.m., we will celebrate the life of Pat Kerrigan. In the afternoon at 2:30, we will be celebrating the union of Sam and Carol Anna in their wedding. So, I want to share that information with you. So, at this time, it's time for us to settle down, get comfortable in your seat, close your eyes. It's that time when we can stop and prepare our hearts and minds for worship during the prelude.
Thank you. Good morning. Stand as you are able and join me in the call to worship. Come to Jesus, you who are thirsty.
Alleluia.
Drink deeply of the Holy Spirit.
Alleluia.
Let your heart overflow with the living water that renews the face of the earth.
Alleluia. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Susie. If you would please remain standing and join me in prayer. Holy God, like a rushing wind, your Spirit moved upon the first disciples and all of those gathered with them on the day of Pentecost. And like a purifying fire, your Spirit seared their hearts and minds with the message of salvation. Send your Spirit upon your church in this time and in this place. Stir up our courage and rouse us for prophetic witness, that we may join with them to proclaim to the world your mighty deeds of power. In Jesus' name we humbly pray. Amen. You may be seated. God has promised that everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Therefore, let us call upon the Lord, confessing our sins. Please join me in the unison prayer of confession that's in your bulletin, but also up on the screen. God of new creation, we confess that we have failed to trust your bountiful goodness. By the power of the Holy Spirit, you brought forth the earth and its creatures in abundance. Yet we hoard earth's resources and refuse to share your gifts. We dishonor your generosity by withholding our charity to those in need. We betray your kindness by dealing harshly with our enemies. We disregard your compassion by severely judging the sins of others. Forgive us. By the power of your Spirit, renew our hearts and free us from sins, that we may enjoy the fullness of your blessing upon all creation. And all God's people say, Amen. Sisters and brothers, God offers forgiveness of our sins and the grace of repentance. Accept God's grace, repent of your sin, and be restored to abundant life. Our opening hymn today is Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Let's please join our voices together. Thank you. We want to continue to pray for those on our prayer list, but we also have some additions that have been added here recently. So let me share them. Cindy Young Harold, Damaris Simpson Goddard, Jeff and Lisa Smith, and also the family of Julia Broom. She recently passed away this week. We'll be adding them to our prayer list. And if you have any other additions, make sure you just send them to pennysands@hotmail.com, and she'll make sure they get added so we can pray for them. And please, those who have the bulletin, pray for them every day, the entire prayer list. Take time to pray for them. That's why we create it, because the power of prayer is immense. So now, let us go to the Lord in prayer, and when I say, Almighty God, I invite you to respond, hear our prayer. Let's go to the Lord. For the church throughout the world, Almighty God, hear our prayer. Inspire the sons and daughters of your church for prophetic witness to your truth, and upon old and young, give clarity of vision to acknowledge your saving power in the world. Almighty God, hear our prayer. Overcome the babble of misunderstanding among the nations, and let your people hear in their own language and recognize in their own culture your unifying message of love. Almighty God, hear our prayer. By your Spirit, renew the earth. Make us good stewards of its resources, and teach us to enjoy its abundance rightly. Almighty God, hear our prayer. For those in need of healing, those who are grieving, those who are lost, among those known to us, God, we pray for all of those in our prayer list today. Send your healing Spirit upon those who are sick in body or mind. Restore them to health, and restore to them the joy of salvation. For our neighbors and members of our civic community, Almighty God, hear our prayer. Teach us to be good neighbors, to live in peace with one another, and in friendship share the joys and burdens of daily life. Almighty God, hear our prayer. Bless our children, protect them from danger, and help parents and caregivers nurture them so they may mature in wisdom and grow in grace. Almighty God, hear our prayer. Bless our enemies and show us how we may do good to them, for the sake of Jesus Christ. Almighty God, hear our prayer. In your mercy, Almighty God, receive our prayers, and according to your wisdom, provide all that we need through Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, as the children of God, let us pray the prayer your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. With thanksgiving for God's gifts to us, let us offer ourselves and the fruits of our labor for God's work in the world. I've already placed in the offering plate everything that we received this week so that we could bless it. Let me take a quick drink. And please join me at this time. Stand for the doxology.
And as we prepare our hearts to listen to the message, as we sing this song, remember that His very breath is what we live for. Join us as we sing "Breathe."
This is my daily bread.
That was beautiful. Thank you. And at this time, Rhonda Thompson will come forward and do our children's moment.
Good morning. Good morning. Today we get to celebrate Pentecost. Pentecost is the day when Jesus' followers come together and God's gift of the Holy Spirit came upon them. The Holy Spirit in Acts 2, verses 1 through 4, the Bible tells us that all of Jesus' followers came together. And as they were together, God sent the Holy Spirit for them. Now, the Holy Spirit is part of the Trinity. We have God the Father, Jesus the Son, and then the Holy Spirit. So, although they couldn't see the Holy Spirit, they knew the Holy Spirit was there. There was wind, and in the Bible it tells us that the wind was so mighty that the sound was rushing and loud, that they couldn't see the Holy Spirit. And then there was leaps, tongues of flames that like bounced on their head, and they could see the flames, but they couldn't see the Holy Spirit. Then there was all at once empowerment upon the people, and they could speak all kinds of languages. And God did that so they could share the message of Jesus Christ with everybody, no matter what language they spoke. So, I know it's kind of hard because we really can't see the Holy Spirit, but let's take a deep breath. Ready? Exhale. Did you see all that oxygen coming into your lungs? No, but we know it's there because we're still breathing, right? That's right. Well, even though we can't see the Holy Spirit, we can trust God that His promise of the Holy Spirit is true. Let's pray. Dear Father, thank you for sending your Holy Spirit to be our teacher and guide us and help us. Help us to listen and obey as He teaches us to tell others about Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Before we go into the scripture, let us pray. Spirit, as we prepare to hear the word, open our hearts and minds this day, entice us with your presence, and speak to us in the language of our hearts, that we may hear your word with understanding and answer your call with confidence. All this we ask in the name of God, who creates, sustains, redeems us. Speak to us, Lord. We, your servants, are listening. Amen. Our scripture today begins in Psalm 104. Psalm 104, verses 24 to 32. 24 through 32. Listen to the word. O Lord, how manifold are your works. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Yonder is the sea, great and wide. Creeping things innumerable are there, living things both small and great, There go the ships and Leviathan that you formed to sport in it. These all look to you to give them their food in due season. When you give to them, they gather up. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things. When you hide your face, they are dismayed. And when you take away their breath, they die and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the ground. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. Who looks on the earth and it trembles, who touches the mountains and they smoke. Then we turn to Acts 2, 1 through 4. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly, from heaven, there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. And our last piece of scripture I want to read today is in 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 12, verses 7 and 11. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. All these are activated by the one and same Spirit who allots to each individually just as the Spirit chooses. The Word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Next, we have a prayer hymn, Spirit Songs, on page 347.
Thank you.
And then the women following Jesus, many of them had been healed, forgiven of sins? He had an odd group of people that was there, and there's many, many others. When you really think about it, those that piled into that room gathered to await the promise of the Holy Spirit, and they were an odd assembly of outcasts, people with questionable pasts, betrayers, and other backgrounds. Yet we need to notice something that I highlighted in verse 4. They were each given the Holy Spirit, each and every one. It was just not to Peter, John, and James, the big three. It was given to everyone gathered there. Men, women, people with light skin, people with dark skin. People who were wealthy, people who were poor, people who were broken, and people who were newly healed. Those who had followed him for 3 years and those who had followed him for just a few days. When the Holy Spirit invaded that space, it did not discriminate. The Holy Spirit was given to each and every one. I don't know about you, when I read that, that gives me such hope. It gives me such hope when I read it that the Holy Spirit was given to each and every one. It gives me hope to know our God does not discriminate. But additionally, because the Holy Spirit did not discriminate, each and every one started speaking in different languages, which then attracted others to hear the gospel. We had people from Galilee. If you go look at Acts 2, 7 through 11, there's people from Galilee, Asia, Egypt, Crete, Judea, Libya, Parthia, which we are Iran, and also various geographical backgrounds. It's a whole list. But ask yourself, why did these people gather? They heard the gospel being said in a familiar language. And because they had something in common with the person speaking, they were attracted to that person and wanted to hear what they had to say. You know, I don't know about you, I like to talk to people who are dog lovers, because it's natural for us to be comfortable gathering with those who have something in common with us, and I love dogs. I like to be with people who hike and talk about what their adventures are and what they got to go do. We talk the same language, we get each other's odd jokes. We're naturally drawn to those that we have something in common with them. You know, and that reminds me of a story I recently heard. Most of you know our conference superintendent, Beth Perry, is retiring, and her replacement will be Russ Abel. He's up in the East District. He's going to be taking two districts. And Russ told the story. He said, you know, with this pandemic going on, he's been home a lot more. And so has his wife. So they started putting up bird feeders. And then he heard people say that there's Orioles out there. And in order to attract an Oriole, he went to go look and research, well, what kind of bird seed do I need to get for the Orioles? And then he read that he needed to slice up an orange, put a half of an orange, and put bright jelly on it. I'm not joking. Slice up half an orange, put it on the post, put bright jelly on it. So he did. What do you think happened? In no time at all, he had Orioles visiting that post. And that made him pause and think. We do this a lot as pastors, just to let you know. That made him pause and think. Were they always here? Were they always up in my trees, and I just didn't know they were there, and I didn't know how to attract them? Or are they flying in new? And as he thought about it, he kept thinking, no, I think they were always here. But I didn't that they would want to come down and interact with me. But once he put out the orange and the grape jelly, they had something in common. And then he got to see them all over the place. And he was very excited about that. And it's funny, you know, one thing about Pentecost does teach us that we need to be able to first communicate in a familiar way with someone before they will be attracted to come close enough to hear the gospel. I want to say that again. One thing Pentecost teaches us is that we need to be able to first communicate in a familiar way with someone before they will be attracted to come close enough to hear the gospel. When you get close enough to hear the gospel, we enable the Holy Spirit to invade that space so that they can experience it also, that person. We are all naturally drawn to those in which we have something in common. Anybody who's ever worked with anyone in any form of addiction knows you need someone who has been there before to walk them through it, because they have something in common. They can understand what they're going through. That's why parents talk to other parents for advice on raising children. Once I, honest to goodness, had a man who was stopping and was trying to tell me at work how I could help my child with this problem they had. So I paused and said, "Oh, really? Well, how many children do you have? You know, are they boys? Are they girls? What sex are they?" He said, "Oh, I have no children." Now, do you think I listened to him anymore after that? No, because we did not have that in common. How about your photographer? You like to talk to other photographers because you have something in common you can talk about. The commonality causes them to trust what each other has to say. So today, I invite you to discover your orange grape jelly concoction. I want you to discover something. What experience do you have that you personally have that others may have in common with you? That experience is your orange and grape jelly concoction that will attract people who are different from you but yet have something in common with you, so they will come closer. When they draw closer, you have the chance to share and hear the gospel. They are hearing it from someone in which they have something in common, which then allows them to trust what you have to say. What new thing do we need to do? So they will ask us, call us, seek us out to hear what we believe. What new thing do we need to do to create an environment so the Holy Spirit can invade this space that you're creating? I don't know about you, but I think I'm going to start with half an orange and some grape jelly and see where it leads from there. Would you please join me in prayer? Gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you in praise. We have a community filled with people wanting to hear about the gospel. They may not even know they want to hear it, like the day on Pentecost. The people who were drawn in did not know what they wanted to hear till they heard it in a familiar language. Lord, give us that language. Give us the orange grape jelly concoction, whatever it is that we need to do to bring people in, because we know they're out there. We just can't see them sometimes, or maybe we choose not to see them. But guide us, Lord, so we can bring them in, share the gospel with them, but even more important, so we can change their lives for the better. Because we know the blessing it is to follow you. In Jesus' name we humbly pray. Amen. Our closing hymn is "They'll Know We Are Christians by Our Love." the 1800s by Christina Rossetti. O God, the Holy Ghost, who art light unto thine elect, evermore enlighten us. Thou who art fire of love, evermore enkindle us. Thou who art Lord and giver of life, evermore live in us. Thou who bestowest sevenfold grace, evermore replenish us. As the wind is thy symbol, so forward our goings. As the dove, so launch us heavenwards. As water, so purify our spirits. As a cloud, so abate our temptations. As dew, so revive our languor. As fire, so purge our dross. Amen. Let's take the light of Christ out into the world.